And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
Good morning.
Morning.
Thank you for joining us for the Board of County Commission Community Relation Advisory Council annual Martin Luther King Essay Challenge and Award and Breakfast Program. I'm Katrina Lunsford, your co-MC for this event.
Oh, you want me to talk now?
Yeah,
okay. I appreciate you. When you said co-MC, I thought you were in charge. My name is Todd Dancer. I'm a county commissioner, and I'm also your co-MC for this event. The breakfast is the climax to the countywide essay challenge and is held in honor and celebration of the life and work of Dr. Martin Luther King. Katrina, please share the specifics of the essay challenge, if you would.
Sure. The essay challenge convened September through November 2017 for students attending school in Polk County in grades K through 12. The essay topics was remember, celebrate, act, King legacy of peace, unity, and justice for all. Each grade level had a specific word limit appropriate for their age group. A first, second, and third place winner was selected for each level, and guess what?
What?
Now, what part of the guess didn't you understand?
Oh.
You're supposed to guess.
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to like bust out a beat about how great it is to be here in Polk County.
It is great to be in Polk County.
It is.
But no better than that, the first place winner for each category will read their winning essay.
That's awesome.
Good morning. It's an honor and privilege to be here at the 16th annual Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Essay Challenge Breakfast. You know, almost 50 years after Dr. King's death, he continues to inspire our generation. Many times we focus on his eloquent words that he spoke, but it would shortchange what he contributed to our society not to focus on his actions. I'm sure many have studied what personal qualities he had that allowed him to achieve so much in his brief life. But I would just like to offer three this morning of many qualities that could be discussed. I think first, no rational person could look at his life and disagree with the fact that he followed his conscience as to what he thought was right. That was, I believe, the foundation for both his words and his actions. Dr. King said there comes a time when one must take a position that is neither safe nor politic, but he must take it because his conscience tells him it is right. I think secondly, any of us that were alive in the 1950s, 1960s, and saw the evening news know that Dr. King kept moving forward regardless of the substantial obstacles and opposition that he faced. Dr. King himself said, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. And then thirdly, he didn't achieve the remarkable things that he did by himself. He had the ability to motivate and inspire others to join his cause. Dr. King said, a genuine leader is not a searcher for consensus, but a molder of consensus. So he didn't sit back and wait on others to come around to his way of thinking. He aggressively went out and motivated and inspired tens or hundreds of thousands or even millions of people to the rightness of his cause and to follow up on his actions. So we in our lives may not be able to achieve all that he did in his life, but if we follow his example of pursuing what is right, always moving forward, and building a consensus for positive change, then we can be a part of making the world a better place. I think that's one of the reasons for the Dr. King holiday and events like this and thousands of others that we will have around our country to recognize a life well lived of a great man, but also to remind us that that's what we should do in our lives. So thank you very much for the opportunity to speak this morning.
Good morning. And welcome, community leaders, school board members, staff, teachers, administrators, and parents. Congratulations to all our students that are here this morning. You are all winners today. But most importantly, you're here because you recognize that Martin Luther King Day is much more than just a holiday. It is about peace, unity, togetherness, diversity, and progress. It is a day to celebrate differences rather than focus on confusion. It is a day that we should be proud to be an American and free citizens. If he was here today, what do you think he would say? Do you think he would be proud of what we have here today in our country? Do you think his speech would be any different than it was when he written it? Do you think he would still be fighting for his dreams to come true? See, Dr. King was a man of substance. He was not one that cared about putting his name up on a sign. He was much more about what impression did he put on your character, on your heart, and how did you react to it? His dream was that we would create unity and share that unity by each and every race, then, now, and in the future. Did you know that everyone here today represents Dr. King's dream? Did you know that when you go to school, work, to the grocery store, or even in your community, you should be exhibiting the dream that Dr. King had of unity? It was never to change the location. It was always to change who we were and to create unity. Actually, it was to spread hope and change throughout our country. As I stand here before you today, I'm reminded of my very own children. I'm reminded of the things that I wanted to instill into them, which are some of the same things Dr. King wanted to make sure we instill in each other and others around us. One was to never give up. No matter what people say about you, your race, never let anyone stop and take things away from you. You never give up. You finish what you start. Never pay evil with more evil. Do things in such a way that everyone will see you as honorable. Do all that you can to live in peace with everyone. Stand up for what you believe in. Don't be silent. This is your way to express yourself. Trust God. Trust is where you should place, and it should be within God. Courage. Always have courage to overcome your fears and be careful of your actions. Live by faith. There will be challenges, but take it one day at a time, step by step. Forgive others. Forgiveness allows you a life without grudges against anyone. Lastly, love others. We will have a better world today if we just learn to love others that are around us. So over this weekend and over the next week and over the next month, you're going to hear speeches of Dr. King. I ask you to listen to one of the most powerful speeches, I Have a Dream. That speech resonates with a lot of people. We've heard it over and over and over. But Dr. King's dream was for a hope and a future. So on Monday, remember, we will celebrate the anniversary of Dr. King, but it's more than just a holiday. So I'm going to leave you with one question that Dr. King asked, and I'm going to ask you today. What are you doing for others? Let's make the world a better place. Thank you.
Good morning. It's my honor to be your sheriff. Now, I've had the opportunity to work in law enforcement my entire adult life. And if you want to know who the best school superintendent is, And the best county manager is that I've ever worked for. You just heard from them. I can tell you, Jackie Bird and Jim Freeman are simply the very best. We're successful in this county. We work in partnerships and we collaborate together. And it's because, first, we like each other. And two, it's not about us, it's about those we serve. And that's what Dr. King did. It wasn't about Dr. King, it was about the community. It was about making the community a better opportunity for everyone. So I commend the young men and women today, the students that wrote the essays. You're awesome. You did a fantastic job. The theme, Remember, Celebrate, Act, King's Legacy of Peace, Unity, and Justice for All, is timely because there's not one of us in this room or in this city or in this county or this state or this nation that doesn't stand on the giant's shoulders that came before us. And Dr. King is one of the greatest giants that came before us. On behalf of the men and women of the Sheriff's Office, I commend all of the students for their work. But you know, I would be remiss if I didn't quote some of my favorite passages from Dr. King, because in my estimation, they're straightforward. They don't hide what he was trying to communicate. That was his strength. He was a great communicator. So let me give those to you once again. We will have to repent in this generation, not merely for the hateful words and actions of the bad people, but for the appalling silence of the good people. The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenges and controversy. My favorite, darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. And then there's, I have decided to stick with love. Hate is too great a burden to bear. And then there's the one that he simply said and made sure that we all in this country understood. We have all come on different ships, but we're in the same boat now. And ladies and gentlemen, we're in this boat together, and if any one of us or any group of us start poking holes in one end of the boat and we don't all run over there together to patch the boat, then it fills with water and we all drown. That's Grady Judd. We must continue to carry out Dr. King's legacy, the dream he imparted to each of us, by working together to make our communities the absolute very best, because they can't be the best if we're not arm in arm, hand in hand, attacking the things that are wrong, supporting the things that are right. Students, you've done much more than write an essay. Much, much more than writing an essay. You are a visionary for our future. You are the leaders for the future. You will be the greatest superintendent one day, and sheriff one day, and county manager one day. And because of you and your excitement and the work you've done, you're already on the path. So remember, celebrate, act, move forward, and remember, we're all servants for each other. May God bless you.
Again, we want to say thank you to our sponsors and to our judges. Our judges actually spent hours grading or evaluating hundreds of essays. So we do want to just give them a small token of appreciation. And for the free breakfast that you received today, it is because of our sponsors. So as I call your name, would you please come to the stage? Dr. Reggie Webb, which was one of our judges for Polk State College. They're all Polk State College staff. Simi Johnson, if you're here. Kathleen O'Donnell, Carol DeMoya, Melvin Thompson, and Otis Wilson. Let's give them a hand as they come. And while they're coming, we'll proceed with recognizing our sponsors. As most of you know, I think this sponsor contributes throughout Polk County, and that is our very own Public Supermarkets Charities Incorporated. We are recognizing them as a diamond sponsor. Our gold sponsors are, as I call your name, please come to the stage as well, Lakeland Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, Mosaic, and TECO, our gold sponsors. And our silver sponsors are Lake Wells Branch of NAACP, Winter Haven Branch of NAACP. Our community sponsors are, or our community partners, Haines City Branch NAACP and Pingio Incorporated.
Again, good morning. I want to thank everyone for your presence today. I want to just share a few things. I'm thankful for the opportunity to share on this committee. Been here since 2012 and just a professional group that works hard for the community. I want to say thank you to a couple of folks that make this happen in our school system. It starts with, once we receive the information, we send that information to Diane Plow, our K-12 director of writing. I don't know if she's here this morning, but I want to say thank you very much. Yes, ma'am, thank you. You make our job easy. And once we receive everything, it comes into our department. I want to thank my secretary, Sheila Keith, for processing those things that happen to go out to the parents. Thank you very much. Now, part of my job also is to seek out the best singers in the state of Florida each year. So this year we went to Bartow High School, and we want to thank Ms. Kenny and the chamber singers, and want to thank her principal for allowing them to come, and the students. Thank you. You all look great, beautiful. Thank you very much. Now, to the parents and students, I want to thank you for participating. And I hope I'm not taking away from the MCs, but I want to thank those principals and those teachers. Let's get you to stand. The principals and teachers that are with the winners here, you guys stand. Thank you guys for the time. Then I want the parents to stand, with parents of the children. Thank you very much. And they're going to call our winners up in a minute. You'll get a chance to see those individuals. Our superintendent stated the other day that she needed to make sure that, and parents, I want you to hear this, on January 24th, our board meeting, they're going to recognize the students also. So here's another plug. I know you got a call from our office, and I know the community relationship office call, but it's on the 24th at 5 o'clock. We want to still celebrate and let the others see the wonderful job here. And thank you for all the officials that are out from our school board. I thank you guys, other members, regionals. Thank you guys very much, the associate superintendents. Thank you guys for being here.
Now for the part that we've been waiting for is the recognition of our essay with Captain Vance Monroe and Kevin Checkerson, followed by the reading of the first winner's essays. Would you come up?
Good morning. Come on now. We're not in church. Sidewalk Baptist. Good morning. Good morning. There we go. There we go. These essays were fabulous. One thing that I've learned over the years is, first, never follow the sheriff after a speech. It's hard to follow that man. Secondly, you definitely don't want to hear me sing, so thank God they brought that choir here. But we're going to go ahead and get started. But before we get started, can we call up the county manager, Mr. Freeman, Superintendent Ms. Byrd, and Sheriff Judd up here to the stage, please? Okay, we'll start. This is for the elementary school, kindergarten through second. Third place winner is Hunter Brantley, second grade, Frostproof Elementary. Second place is Joshua Diaz, second grade, Frostproof Elementary. First place is LaDerica Henderson, second grade, Frostproof Elementary. Now we're going to go to elementary school grades 3 to 5. Third place is Arlene Quintero, fifth grade, Ben Hill Griffin Jr. Second place is Noah Jacob, fifth grade, Lincoln Avenue Academy. First place is Corian A. Abram, fifth grade, Lincoln Avenue Academy. Now on to middle schools. Third place, it's going to be eighth grade, from Lawton Child, is going to be Chloe Winslow. Second place is Abel Abraham, eighth grade, Lawton Childs Middle. First place is Hansel Ramirez, sixth grade, Lake Gibson Middle. Those are your middle school winners there. Okay, now on to high schools. Third place is Carter Blair, freshman, Auburndale High School. Second place is Jacob Lucas, Jr., George Jenkins High School. First place is Arteta Mathis, freshman, Auburndale High School. And these are our high school winners. Thank you. We're going to start off with LaDerica Henderson.
Hold on one second, sweetie.
Here.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
You got it, Mama. She said she has it.
Martin Luther King Jr. was an incredible man. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was born in Atlanta, Georgia. When he was a boy, all children could not go to the same bathroom or school. Black and white children were treated very differently because of their skin color. He believed in living peacefully with others. He was sad when he could not play with his friends because they had different skin colors. Martin Luther wanted to grow up to be a preacher just like his father. Martin Luther had a dream that was for his children to not be judged of the color of their skin. One day, he led a march because black people wanted to have jobs like white people. He led a march because he wanted people to believe that they would be free one day. Martin Luther had big dreams. I can help live out Martin's dream in my community by using my manners. When somebody is giving me something and treating others with respect. In my school, I can continue Martin's dream by treating others the way I would want to be treated.
And now, Corian Abram.
Martin Luther King was born January 15, 1929, in Atlanta, Georgia. He died on April 4, 1968, at the young age of 39 in Tennessee. During his young life, he had four children with his wife, Coretta Scott. His four children were named Yolanda, Martin, Dexter, and Bernice King. Martin's parents were Martin I and Alberta Williams. Martin Luther King's siblings were Christina and Alfred King. He grew up to be a Baptist preacher and received many awards, such as Nobel Peace Prize, Presidential Medal of Freedom, and Congressional Gold Medal. To remember him, almost every city in the United States of America has a street named Martin Luther King Jr. Street, either avenue or boulevard. One of Martin's most popular speeches was about your race does not matter, white or black, you can still be friends, go to the same school, use the same bathroom and water fountain. He had a dream that different races can do the same things together. Dr. King was the only non-president to have a national holiday named for him. Centers and memorials are in different places around the U.S. as a part of Dr. King's legacy. His wife started the Center for Nonviolent Social Change. Hopefully someday soon each of us can visit a center and learn more about what Dr. King stood for. If you have ever participated in a Martin Luther King parade, as I have, you will know the real sense of walking for unity, peace, and justice, and having fun doing it. And I plan to not be a part of division, always doing the right thing, and always being kind to others is the best way. Surrounding myself with positive people and encouraging negative people to speak positive is a goal I can set for myself and others around the world. As I grow up, I will try my best to deliver messages that Martin Luther King Jr. will be proud to hear.
Next is Mr. Hansel Ramirez.
Here we go. Martin Luther King, one of the greatest civil rights fighters of all time. Martin Luther King Jr. was born on January 15, 1929, in Atlanta, Georgia. Martin Luther King Jr. was a Baptist minister and a civil rights activist, and had a seismic impact on race relations in the United States of America, beginning in the mid-1950s. When Martin Luther King died, it was a catastrophe for the people. He got shot. The bullet exploded his head from the street next where Martin Luther King was. The dream can be kept alive by doing what we're doing. For example, having a black president like Barack Obama, having children from different cultures and races in the same table, sharing activities and knowledge. The most important thing is not to be a racist person, but even though there's still some people that do not like black and Hispanic persons, we still can do it. Despite this, the American people is getting better over the years and has learned to accept and share with other persons no matter their skin color. The dream Martin Luther King started is way better now, and we can see there are three different races in the same table. For example, in my own school, there is a white, black, and Hispanic having lunch together and in the classroom as well. So the dream Martin Luther King had is coming through, and we can help with that by not judging people, but respect them, and that way we can respect ourselves. And don't judge people because of their skin color and appearance. The best way we can keep the dream alive is not making people feel bad for their skin color. So don't be a bad person. Be a part of Martin Luther King's dream. Be respectful. Let's become a great country in the way Martin Luther King dreamed for us. USA can be an example for those countries where the human rights are not still arrived, and we can see, show them that all humans, despite their color and ethnicity or gender, could have the same rights and live in peace and love each other. We all have the same rights, rights to study, rights to work and receive a salary, rights to practice any religion or to not practice any religion. In fact, they apply our Constitution the same way to every person in this country. We as children can contribute to this dream. We should be respectful with our parents, teachers, and all persons who are around us. We can help with our friends and respect them as well. For example, if there's a child from another country in our classroom, we should help him or her to introduce to our culture and language, and not avoid him or her because looks different or speaks another language that is not English. This way, we can contribute to fighting the bullying as well. At the end, I should like to add that Martin Luther King dream is a goal for all American people, and I should keep us together in order to get this dream come finally true in all its aspects. Unfortunately, in the news, we can see there is still people with old ways of thinking, but we should make these people understand and show them the better way to live in peace and get every person to have the same rights. Thank you.
And now, Ms. Arteta Mathis.
Right there. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. had a dream that one day this nation will rise up to live out the true meaning of his creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equally. Dr. King envisioned that nobody should be judged because of the color of their skin or the way they look or dress. When the architects of our republic wrote the magnificent word of the Constitution and their Declaration of Independence, they were just signing a promissory note that stated that every American was to fall heir. And it said that all Americans, black men as well as white men, would be guaranteed the unalienable rights of life, but yet that did not happen. That was a lie. Dr. King had a good mindset on how the world should be ran and how everything should be set up and work. He wanted blacks to live in a world of freedom and religious. But instead, we got a world of hate, drama, and dishonor. But it wasn't right when blacks got on a bus and we had to sit in the way back of the bus And it was also a little wall that separated us and the blacks from the whites. And if you dared to sit in one of the white people's seats and you were black, you would be asked to move or you would go to jail. They did not like for you to talk back to them because they felt as if they had control over blacks and that they could talk to us anyway and that our morals was less than theirs. They did not expect us to say anything back. And if you was to say anything back and they felt you to be a threat, they would call the police and the police would beat you down and take you to jail. And they got away with a lot of things because no one stood up for us until Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Dr. King was an outgoing man who spoke his mind no matter what anyone thought or how they felt about it. Dr. King said as long as a Negro could not vote in Mississippi, that there would never be satisfied. And I agree, because how are you going to say we have equal rights when people cannot vote and you making our kids go to separate bathrooms from the whites, you putting whites in better school systems with better education and blacks go to bad school with 50 students in one classroom with one teacher? Is it because they do not have enough money to hire more teachers? Because they are broke? Because the whites won't give us any money? No, that's wrong. They just don't want to share because they are rude. Also, that is so cruel and mean because you're making blacks feel like we are worth the dirt we clean up. He also inspired this nation when he said, "This sweltering summer of Negroes, discontent will not pass until there is an involuntary autumn of freedom and equality." He said that in 1963 was not the end, it was the beginning. He wanted to push it to the full extent, and those who said that Negroes needed to blow off steam will have a rude awakening if the nation returns to business as usual. Neither will rest until Negroes are granted the right of citizenship. Dr. King did a lot for blacks, and that's why I praise him, because he fought for black people's rights to make sure we did not grow up in a world so full of hate and danger. He wanted us all to be equal and have the same rights and not have to always fight and get thrown in jail for trying to get your point across or for using the white bathroom. And it's so crazy how the world has changed so much today. It's not perfect, but it is better than it was in 1963. That was a bad time. There were a lot of things happening because everyone did not get along and was not equal. Dr. Martin Luther King lived a great life and finally got to see his wish come true, which was to see freedom ring, letting blacks know we were free and all equal. Now I ask myself every day if we could change one thing in this world to make sure this world would be a better and safer place for our future kids to grow up in, what would it be?
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these are our winners of this essay competition.